Figma Make is a very powerful tool that designers have been using for discovery in the last few months since it was released. In this video, I am going to take you to some advanced practices in Figma Make. I want to show you how I refine my prompts and teach you some prompting basics so that you can get better results. In addition to that, I want to show you some of the new features released so you're able to attach a library or your design system library so that you can utilize it and make the result look more like your product. If you're new to Figma Make, I highly recommend you watch my video that I'm linking to you above that walks you through the very basics and how you can use it. From my experience in the last 4 months, it has been a very wonderful tool for the discovery phase of the design process. Very often, I have collaborated with product managers to sit together, come up with a very quick proof of concept that we can refine. So the first thing that I want to address here today is why prompting matters. If you're new to AI, to LLMs, to speaking to AI in common language, which was referred to as vibe coding when this whole thing started, LLMs stand for large language models. Think of it like an advanced text prediction system trained on a massive amount of data. Books, articles, conversations, code. It does not think like a human, but it's very good at recognizing patterns in language and generating text, instruction, or design that match your request. In Figma Make or any Gen AI tool, the LLM is the engine that interprets your prompt and turn it into design output. So it's really good at reflecting how you communicate with it. That's why when you communicate with emotion with ChatGPT, it replies to you with extreme emotion. It mirrors your emotion right back at you. When you say please and use words like this, it responds to you with kindness as well. However, that's not the best use of your LLM because there's a limit on the words that you send. Even the word please is costly. So what are the key rules that we need to know when communicating with an LLM like Figma Make? Here are some of the highest tips. First, you have to be very, very specific. Be specific. Talk to it as if you're talking to an intern who is assisting you. What's really interesting is when you're working with Gen AI, our whole workflow is changing. You know, people were concerned that AI will take their job, but the way I see it is AI will promote you to a manager in your job. AI will become your direct report, your assistant, your right hand. Instead of doing the work, you are telling AI what to do, what you want it to do. And the more clear and specific you are with your instruction, the better it is with the results it's generating. So instead of saying something like, make a nice homepage, you want to try something like design a homepage for a travel booking website. Include a hero image at the top, a search bar, and 3 featured destinations in a grid layout. Here is what design a homepage gave us. It's a nice website, but it's very generic. It could be anything because we didn't give it any specifications. So it's very unlikely that it matches what you're trying to create. However, our second prompt that was about the travel booking website was very, very specific. If you remember, we asked it to create a search bar as well as 3 cards of the main destinations, the 3 most popular destinations laid out in a card grid. And as you can see, it created exactly that. The second tip is give it context. Tell it who you are and what the goal is. An example of context is to specify what you want the LLM to be. You are a senior UX designer helping me create wireframes for a fitness app targeting busy professionals. The third tip is to break it down. LLMs handle structured instructions better. So if you write the full paragraph, they will not be able to break it down. They will tend to ignore the information in the middle. So use bullet point or numbered lists to give it more clarity. An example would be 1, create the wireframe for the home screen. Add a navigation bar with 4 tabs. Use minimal clean design style. The next tip is iterate. Don't expect perfection on the first round. especially in Figma Make, that first prompt is very, very important. So you want to structure your first prompt to contain most of the things that you want. It's almost like you drew it on paper, you visualized it, and now you want to describe it for the LLM. And here is my advanced tip for you. What I do is, once I craft what I want, I generally go to ChatGPT, I put my prompt in there, and I say, help me craft a clear prompt for Figma Make. This is what I'm trying to create. And I list that for ChatGPT and I ask it to organize it specifically for Figma Make. That's what I always do with my first prompt, which gives me a very close result to what I'm actually trying to create. But once that first prompt is complete, that's when we start clicking and editing. We use the point and edit to refine further on what we want to create, and we can add enhancements as we go. Lastly, if there's something specific you wanted to do or not to do, always give it that very specifically. Example, avoid gradients and avoid stock photo-like illustrations. Now that we covered prompting, let's look at the recent tools added to Figma Make. You can import from your Figma library an existing file you're working with. This was already there, but it's more prominent. Now, you can also add a screenshot, of course, but the select from library is a new addition that is super helpful, and I'm going to show you how to do that. Before that, let's look at the settings. There are additional files that can give context to the LLM. If you click on edit guidelines, you will be able to give more context to your LLM. That's not always very helpful. Do it only when necessary for developers. Same with adding style guides, if you had specific styles. To attach a library, you will see there is Figma documentation in that link, and I've also added it in the video description here, that shows you how to export the library for Figma Make. You don't only want to add the UI kit to a design file. You want to open the UI kit file itself and click on open file. That will take you to the actual file in the community and you can open it in Figma. It asks you to make a copy of it and you can choose whatever team where you have a professional license or an education license. It has to be a full seat plan. Then once you open that file, go back to your assets again and click publish. It's asking me to move it to a team that is already existing. So I'm doing that. And that's when I want to publish this library. You will see there is an indication at the bottom that says export this file for Figma Make, but only files that are published, only libraries that are published can be used in Figma Make. So I will do this. I will click publish for this library, and it takes some time. You will see the notification at the bottom. Once all the components of the library are published, you will see that completed notification. That's when we can go back to publish the file specifically for Figma Make. And now you will see at the very bottom, the Figma Make has become a blue active button that I can actually click on, export to Figma Make. And now once again, there's a bottom alert notification letting me know it's extracting the library data. Once that is complete, it lets you know and asks if you want to go to Figma Make. So I'm gonna click on that. It will open a new window for me. Now to test this, I'm going to attach the watchOS library first, and then now that it's attached here, I will paste my prompt. I am going to use the prompt that we created in ChatGPT for the Apple Watch OS. We had a very well crafted first prompt that we created previously. So with both the library and the first good prompt that we created, and look at this result that we've created. Obviously, Figma Make has leveraged the UI kit, as well as all the instruction we've given it to create a very specific UI. this doesn't look too realistic for me because on the Watch OS, there is no tab bar. This is more specific for the iPhone, but I think it was trying to follow the instructions we've given. This is not perfect, but it's definitely leveraging the exact component from the Watch OS and mimicking the style. And there you have it. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or comments that you want to give me or other questions about things you want to learn, please leave them in the comments. See you in the next one.